Hi, and welcome to Sister Strong, a video series and podcast about possibility. I'm your host, Betsy Wiersma. This podcast is our way to share insights, ideas, and experiences that we all need as we stand together, Sister Strong. This is things for your toolkits and ideas on how you can help the community. And we're so happy today to have our special guest, Cheryl Talley from Catholic Charities, and you know her from her role supporting the Samaritan House. Welcome, Cheryl.
Oh, thank you so much. And thank you for doing this. This is such a great opportunity to talk about what we're doing, but also just to the sisterhood is such a great element as well. So thank you for letting us talk about what we do at Catholic Charities and being that conduit to the sisters.
Well, hey, I first would like to point out that you and I both have great taste in glasses. And
we do.
If we just could wear blue cat eye glasses, the world would be a better place. So thank you very much.
Makes me happy just wearing the glasses.
I think that you are very stylish. So that my glasses match you is a compliment I am taking for me because I think you're stylish. So let's get the
right back at you.
Let's get eyeglass fashion out there early so we got the important things on the table.
Priorities.
We are sharing Cheryl's screen today because we are going to talk about one of the things about love is the antivirus, right? First, self-care, love yourself. The second thing, though, is love your community and help others, because that will plump up our immune system when we know we are part of the solution and making a difference. So, Cheryl, will you just kind of go through what's happening with Catholic Charities, what's happening with the Samaritan House, the women and the families? We are also curious to know.
Yeah, well, I would love to talk about it. So just talking a little bit about Catholic Charities at large, I mean, Samaritan House is one of the many things that we do, and we are the largest women's shelter in Colorado, but that is just one aspect of what Catholic Charities does in the community. Last year, we served about 105,000 people in our entire year. That's unduplicated number of people. That's how they always like to calculate it. So you can imagine that when this impacted, when COVID-19, impacted our community, it's really impacting the people who are living on the margins probably the most, because that ability to do social distancing and self-isolation is not usually in their cards when they're in a shelter, you know. So, and a lot of the people that we're serving, even our early childhood education centers, about a third of the children are experiencing homelessness. And most of the families are, you know, experiencing poverty in some significant way. So this is a great impact to those people. So we have been really focusing on how we can continue to serve them, but keep them safe and healthy as well. So that's been the priority, and also keeping our staff safe and healthy as well. So we have been working with the city and county of Denver, the city of Greeley, the city of Fort Collins, the state of Colorado, as well as with all the federal, CDC, all the agencies, to making sure that we are not only meeting the expectations, but we put in place many measures to protect our residents in our shelters and the students and all the people that we served. We put it in place before they were even required, so to make sure that we were really keeping people healthy and safe.
So let's just unpack that a little bit, because you're so close to it, you know all the moving parts. So there's a lot of schools impacted, right? So Catholic Charities runs a lot of Catholic schools. So you've got that component. Mm-hmm. Then we know, because camp really is, more intimately connected to the Samaritan House, but then there's the new family floor, and then mm-hmm. there's the veterans that you serve. So
right.
in normal, if there's ever going to be normal again, right? The shelter would open up in the evening. People would come in at 4 and get a meal. Is that function still happening? And tell us a little bit about like the family floor, the veterans, and what's happening with the normal meal service.
Okay, so it's still normal. Everything is still normal in the sense that they are not necessarily leaving during the day. So they are, we are not taking in new residents on the family floor and in the veterans group. The women's emergency shelter, they come in normally, and like yesterday with the storm, they came in early. And they are getting meals and everything. Life is as normal as possible. So they're not getting, their services haven't changed. We are seeing some in like our Greeley and our Fort Collins they're not taking in as many emergencies, because we have to make that space of social distancing a little bit more. But everybody has beds that we know of. We're working on making sure that everyone's covered. So their life is similar to what we're experiencing, where they're going through their daily routines as much as they can, but we're self-isolating and keeping everybody in-house and not bringing in new people in on our family floor or in our veterans program. But the Women's Emergency Shelter, which is a separate program, that's continuing as normal. The difference is that we're not having the same meal services because we want to not have them meet and gather in social in the social community centers.
Yeah, cool.
So they are getting brown bags and taking it back to their rooms. You know, they are so trying to minimize as much interaction as possible. And then we also just have the ability to, we don't have as many volunteers that are able to come and help cook. So that's also limiting what we can do. So we have seen a decrease in volunteers across the board at Catholic Charities, but at this point, they're still getting their three meals a day. There are still residents at the shelter. We have tried to maintain as much of a normal sense of normalcy as possible.
Right. So one of my favorite parts is your warehouse, where our friend yes. Bobby is the king. I'm saying that because he deserves to be honored as king because he works so hard there. And of course, the Camp Experience Network gives everything we can to the warehouse at the Samaritan House that is free shopping for everyone involved. Mm-hmm. Talk a little bit about the expansion of what some of your services, how you're having to take over some of the food service roles of others that had to close.
So we at Catholic Charities called Bobby Saint Bobby because he is really an angel on earth. I mean, he is amazing. He's tireless in his and just put good thoughts and prayers out for Bobby because he's been working overtime. So, at Samaritan House is the distribution center for all of Catholic Charities. That's 2301 Lawrence Street downtown. So they are going to be coordinating with Food Bank of the Rockies and be another distribution center for Food Bank because a lot of the smaller food banks can't open up because a lot of their volunteers are seniors and or they're located in school and churches and which have basically shut down their ability to use their facility. So we're going to be taking on a lot of that. And a lot of our early childhood education teachers are actually stepping in and boxing food. That's going to be going to, right now, when it was going first to the families that we know are struggling in the ECE, in the early childhood education, but then we're going to start doing more distribution to the community. So we'll see more of that happening over the next couple of days. It's just yesterday got approved, so that's new. And then we'll be opening up more distribution centers. We're working on locations right now. So it's a Little Flower Assistance Center is one of the distribution center that's over in Aurora. And you can get all that information. We'll have it on our online. But right now it's kind of fluid every day. We're figuring out where we're going to put things and how we're going to manage the distribution. So we're still working on that. But
well, great. Well, you know, the sisterhood really wants to help. And so many of us, you know, I happen to be a little in the age range. I'm not quite as young as some of the young and healthy. However, you know, I think we can all figure out what we can do. So let's look a little bit around the website. So if someone's interested in finding out what the needs are, of course, cash needs, we'll kind of get to that at the very end. But if somebody has some time or energy or could deliver meals or could help, could you show us around the website a little bit?
Sure. So if ccdenver.org, we just put this little information button on here. And if you click through, it'll bring us to the landing page of all the support and needs for Catholic Charities. So for example, donating closures for places that are not, this is also for our clients as well. Wish list items, we're going to be uploading all those items that are needed and gifts in kind, those kinds of ideas. But and then any links that we have that we're, you know, any updated information so people can just learn more about what's going on. And then volunteer opportunities, always have an opportunity to volunteer if you are if you're not in that risk category, because obviously we want to avoid, anybody getting severe symptoms and from the disease. And so But this is the place to go, ccdenver.org. And then for more information, you can click through to the ccdenver.org/COVID-19. And we also have a little pandemic prayer. So just to keep everybody praying and keeping us all, you know, in our the right mindset. I think if we have to make sure that we're all taking care of ourselves physically as well as spiritually and emotionally during this time. So that's what we're trying to do and help. So it's not just about people that we serve everyone. So I always say, you know, seven ministries, one purpose, to serve all people. And I mean all people, the givers and the receivers. So we really appreciate everybody. So
I always say, I have no brand preference for my God, is what I say.
Yeah, that's like, true.
You know, whether you are, you know, a Catholic, a generic Christian, a Buddhist, whoever you are, there's just, for me, one great, big, huge God that just wants us all to come together, have faith, choose faith over fear, and really use this time to know, be still and know, you know, that I'm God, and like, take a big breath. I was saying to you before we got on the call, 10 years ago, the Amazon delivery system wasn't in place. 10 years ago, we weren't all fluid online with Zoom for our businesses. You know, 10 years ago, we didn't have high-speed internet that allowed us all to communicate. So, you know, if you have to go through something bad, I kind of believe a really good God made Amazon for the purpose of delivering chocolate, is what I'm saying.
You know? Yes, chocolate. These are essentials. See,
so there's
that aisle was empty, by the way, in the King Supers. But
yeah. I mean, you know, I got the last poor homeless sweet potato, and it was already broken in half, and I think someone left it. And I said, "Dear smart sweet potato, I don't want you to be alone here in the inn. I will take your poor damaged self home and enjoy you." So I'm trying to create a little bit of humor in the midst of this, because again, I believe, you know, we are all sent here to do our part and to serve really big. So thank you for showing us around the website. If someone wants to contact you again, and if they would like to donate, of course, good hard cash, that is what I was able to do quickly. And I encourage anyone that's got $25 that can do that, tell them how to donate cash.
Yeah. So again, I would go back to the website. You can go to that COVID site. There's always this opportunity here. Go directly to the donate on our website, CC Denver. You know, here's the thing. We appreciate anything. So it could be $5, $25. It doesn't really matter. You know, at this point, this is kind of outside of our budget, right? We are now taking on some more responsibilities that we didn't have before. A lot of our, you know, so anything you can do is helpful. I think that, you know, helping the most vulnerable is a way to make you feel like you're doing something as a community. So it's making me feel better. You know, like my job is helping others right now. And it's when you, it really makes you reflect about why you do what you do. And when you're in a situation like this, and when we really pull together as a country, as a community, as Coloradans, I think it's just important that we support the people who cannot, they have no options, you know? So, you know, we're lucky that we have this. We're lucky that we can communicate. Not everybody has the same abilities to do that, and they're scared. And so our job is to assuage those fears and to make sure that we can help them and make them feel like we're there for them. So, and we are, you know, one thing that I've noticed in the past 2 weeks is an amazing ability of our staff to step it up, and without even, a thought, they started jumping in and thinking, how can we make this work? And, you know, it is amazing to listen to. It's a very uplifting to know that there are people out there whose job is just to take care of others, and we can't do that without the support of everybody. So, you know, we really appreciate, you know, our volunteers, our donors, our supporters. You know, and they're coming through in spades. I have to tell you, we put out an email yesterday. Within, 5 hours, we had $50,000. So, which is going to go a long way for all these unexpected tasks and, you know, things we have to purchase, you know, and all the cleaning supplies. And it just is an amazing thing. So I appreciate everybody's help. And thank you so much.
Yeah, well, that's why we call it Sisters Strong, Cheryl. And we will not only pray for the world, we'll pray for you and your team, your leadership, everyone on the front lines. And now, since he's not the king, he is Saint Bobby now. Saint Bobby. And I'm going to figure out what I can deliver when I deliver everything downtown this weekend, like roast beef sandwiches, a big bag of Arby's or something for all of them. You know, like, I got to come up with something good. And then they'll have to just trust that, you know, it went from Arby's to them and I'll pass it through the door with my stuff. Yeah. But thank you so much for being
Thank you for being a part of the network.
Thank you all for listening to Sister Strong, a video series and podcast about possibility. We are part of the Global Sisterhood Podcast Network, women sharing uplifting ideas, connections, and love for each other and the world. Please share our helpful messages with others that are looking for this kind of energy and ideas and want to make a difference in our community in one of the great ways, which is supporting Catholic Charities and all the great missions, including our sisters and brothers at the Samaritan House. I'm your host, Betsy Wiersma.